welcome to Sankofa Studios, where we have conversations about art, art history, contemporary art, and all things around the Black American arts tradition. We dig deep into the places where art and sociology meet to explore some critical ideas as it relates to Black American identity and expression. Welcome back. today we're going to talk about the mask. There's something about the mask and African art tradition. And you hear a lot of people, I've heard a lot of people over the years talk about masks, especially my people. We say they get a little scared of masks being in their houses. And we're going to dig into that a little bit and give you a little bit of my philosophy about why that fear is there about the mask. in the early 20th century, you had a lot of artists like Pablo Picasso, Andre Durain, and others who would use these African masks as a baseline for a lot of their works. And in fact, like styles like Cubism and Fauvism and other styles borrowed from that aesthetic, that African aesthetic, and kind of moved Western art, was started to move Western art away from just figure painting, because it was a lot of figure painting happening, Western art, up until that point. And again, testament to that African contribution to American art, but Western art as a whole was influenced. the bold designs, the abstract patterns, the colors, there's a beauty there that gets overlooked a lot of time. We're gonna go over some of them and look through some masks. And as I'm talking, I hope you can dig into these masks a little bit, vibe with me with these. From all across Africa, from north to south, you find all these different variations of masks, and they provided different functions. Some were used for warfare, some were used for funeral rites, some were religious, some were just works of art, some of them were wall, home decor, and that fear, I believe, comes from, and this is just my opinion, it comes from, I believe, our indigenous memory. Those masks remind us of something that we lost, and the experience associated with that loss creates a type of fear, because we don't know why we're afraid of them. The mask is not going to do anything to you. I'm in here alone right now. I got a mask right here, and I got another mask right here. I don't feel threatened at all. But the masks are, maybe you saw a war mask that's intended to strike fear, or a death mask. There were even masks for sickness that were intended to represent different types of disease or illness. Urugu is a destructive mask that was probably pretty frightening, and some of us saw some of those images when we were young. And then, you know, a popular culture, in America throughout the 20th century, we absorbed this negative connotation with African aesthetics and African art. While at the same time, again, you have people like Pablo Picasso who are reproducing these masks, and to this day, as they've made a mint off of them. But if you go down, the great John Henry Clark once said that our people were brought to the Americas from that west coast of Africa, and people dispute this. That's another conversation, maybe an orator of some kind can clarify for you. But the great John Henry Clark would state that our people came from the landmass between Mauritania and Angola. And that's where I focus a lot of my attention on as far as the mask goes. You got different cultures, the Bale, the Biombo, the Wa Plank, the Dine people, the Kola, the Kwele, and we can go on and on and on and on, the Pende, the Punu. There's just so many civilizations in that large landmass, that big piece of space, that illustrate some of those indigenous memories. And for me, they bring back fond memories, the indigenous memories that come to my mind when I see these masks. They're fond memories. There's nothing negative about it. And if you look at some of these masks, the things that they represent, just the beauty of them, the craftsmanship, if we dig into the craftsmanship, some of these masks are, you know, over a century old, some of which may even be as much as, you know, 300, 400, 500 years old, and you take into consideration the tools that were used to create these masks and these smooth surfaces, it's pretty mind-blowing and beautiful to see it. I've tried to make a mask myself. Didn't come out that great. It wasn't that great. So, and that's with modern tools. So I take my hat off to these early artists and the works that they created, and these little pieces of the culture that they left behind, almost like breadcrumbs they left behind for us to trace back, you know, and get a glimpse into their everyday life and their cultural experience, their pre-colonial cultural experience, I should say. Because the cultural experience of African people around the globe was impacted by colonization tremendously. So I like to describe it in terms of pre-colonial and post-colonial. These works of art that were not yet influenced by European influence or invasion. So I just wanted you to vibe with some of these masks, get a look at them, and tell me what you think about them. Hit me at sankofastudios27@gmail.com. I'll put it somewhere on the screen where you can see it. And maybe we could discuss some of these masks. And before anybody asks, no, I don't have all of these masks. As a matter of fact, I don't have any of these masks that you're seeing right now on the screen. These masks are in museums. Speaking of colonization, some of these masks were taken, and they are in museums in France, in Paris, France, and Germany, and Switzerland, and across Europe, and even in America. So even the people, the cultures, were still around. They may not even have access to some of these works of art, and that's a shame. It's shameful. But yeah, I just really want you to vibe with these, get a look at them, and let's lose that fear and embrace the beauty around some of these indigenous memories that we have. It's worth it, and it could inspire your art. It can inspire your painting. It can become an inspiration for your drawing, your sketching, or whatever type of art you get into, your wood carving. And it gives you an opportunity to dig deep. And maybe, like some of those great artists that we've discussed, Lois Milo Jones and Aaron Douglas and Norman Lewis and all these other artists who would take, well, I won't say Norman Lewis, I'll go back a little bit on that one, but they would take glimpses from civilizations long gone and merge them with contemporary society and give us a glimpse into our future, essentially, what could possibly be. You know, these projects or these apartment buildings standing next to pyramids, or this this African mask that looks like your auntie, you know, that type of thing. So, yeah, again, just something to vibe with, give you guys a glimpse at it, and let's shake that fear. Let's shake the fear and start moving in this direction. Let's get a grip culturally and start embracing the beauty of this aesthetic and add our own touch to it, because foundational Black Americans are a unique culture in the world. We're not from the continent of Africa. However, we are, in this world, powerhouses in the shaping and the moving and the molding of culture, of contemporary culture. And we would like to put our hands on this art world and start to express ourselves using the visual arts, just as our ancestors did with these masks. So with that said, again, if you have any questions, this is just a quick something I just wanted to put out there and give everybody a chance to view. You can send me your questions to sankofastudios.com, send me a message. Of course, subscribe, like this video, and share it. Sankofastudios.com or sankofastudios27@gmail.com. And again, vibe with these, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace.